DocuSign tutorial for beginners. Welcome everybody. I'm going to show you the basics of DocuSign and how you can set this website up. So DocuSign is an e-signature website that makes your life easier. Once you have created your DocuSign account, we are taken to this homepage right here. So the first thing that we want to do, obviously, is create our signature before we sign any documents and important other papers. So right here where it says signed by, we can create our signature. But before that, if you want to upload an image for our account, we can press on this icon right here, add profile photo, and just by selecting upload, we can upload our own face or our company logo. So that's how we add a profile photo. Now, the most important part, like I said, is creating our signature. I'm going to show you how you can do this. So just click on this one called sign by. So just click on this. And as you can see here, we can write our full name as well as our initials. I have written the name of my YouTube channel, NetHelp, and then the initials, NH. So right here, as you can see, we have different styles of signature. So we can choose one of those and it will show us what it's going to look like. So we got different fonts. As you can see right here, we have a variety of fonts. We even have the basic one that doesn't look handwritten. But for example, let's say we want to choose this one, and this is what the recipients will receive when we signed documents. However, we don't have to choose from one of these presets. We can even draw ourselves. So if we want to write our signature right here, we can just use our mouse and then we can write our actual signature like so. So NH, let's pretend this is my signature. Going to draw it like this, and then here we have to write our initials. So again, I'm just going to do NH for this tutorial, and then as you can see, after we have filled in both of these spaces right here, then we can just click on create, and as you can see, signed by, and it takes this this font that we just created. Or if you already have a signature ready, then you can upload your signature by pressing this button, as well as uploading your initials right here. And the accepted formats are GIF or GIF, JPEG, PNG, BMP, and the max file size is 200 KB. So you might want to go with JPEG for this. But that is how you set up your signature in DocuSign. So let's say that we have set up our signature, we have everything ready. Now, what are the other tabs that we have right here for the website? Well, at the very homepage, you will see this: actions required, waiting for others, expiring soon, and completed. This means all of the actions that you need to take that require your signature and documents that you need to sign. So the good thing with DocuSign is that you need to, or you're able to access the documents directly from here. So if we press on it, we're taken to the manage tab. So we just went from the home tab right here to the manage tab. So from the manage tab right here, as you can see, we have envelopes, we have inbox, sent, drafts, and deleted. Obviously here you will receive everything that you need to sign, so directly in your inbox. Here you will have a copy of your sent documents that need signing. Then drafts here, if you haven't saved anything, or if you haven't saved something, it will be taken to this place right here called drafts, and deleted, of course, that's obvious. Now, right here for bulk send and power forms, this is actually a feature that requires payment. So you need to upgrade your plan if you want to send this. Save time, so on and so forth. Generate, distribute envelopes at a scale with your recipient list. If we click on upgrade, it is going to take us to the payment page. Just give it some time. And as you can see here, If we want a personal account, it's €9 per month. But if we want a standard account, it requires a standard account, it's going to be €23 per month. And if we want a business account, then €38. So I'm just going to go back. Okay, so this is the manage option right here, the second one. And basically here in the inbox, like I said, you will receive all of the documents you need to sign. The sent one is the documents you will have sent to your employees, and then drafts and deleted. Okay, here you can also organize it by creating folders. I forgot to mention this. All right, so we've taken a look at the home page and the manage page. What about templates? Well, templates, as you might have guessed from the name itself, you create a template which you can use to send to people so you don't have to write the same information over and over again, apply the same images. And I'm going to show you how it works. Okay, so after we have clicked on templates right here, my templates, we can just select create template. Okay, so here you will name the template name, so company description, example company letter, and here is actually where you add the files. So for example, let's say we have a pre-made Word document and we have to send it to all of our employees for them to sign, then you just click on upload and you select the document itself. And here where it says add recipients, we write their emails, their names, and of course their role. And here's where we select what they need to do. They need to sign, whether they need to sign it in person, whether they can receive a copy, and whether they need to view it. So right here, if we want to add other options as well, we can add an access code so people who aren't authorized can't get access to this document, as well as a private message. And of course, we have the advanced settings here. So after we have added one person, then we can add another recipient, so on and so forth, until you have all of your company's employees. And here you can add a message to this document. So for example, if you want to add a message to everybody, then here's where you write it. Now, frequency of reminders, you can remind people every few days, as you can see right here, every 0 days is selected. An administrator must allow senders to override account defaults. So you need to be an administrator if you want to change how often they get reminded. Okay, so that's how you create a template for DocuSign. Okay, so we've taken a look at home, manage, templates, and reports. Now, what are reports? So the next tab right here, reports, you will get all of your analytics for the selected period right here. So for example, 30 days, last month and last 3 months, you will see all of your signed documents, all of your outgoing documents, what your employees have signed, so on and so forth. Basically the analytics tab right here, as you can see, we have envelope success as well as envelope turnaround. And here you can get some more information about the pros of using an e-signature website like DocuSign. Okay, so we've taken a look at these four options, and the last one that we have to take a look and is arguably the most important is the settings tab right here. So I'm just going to click on settings and I'm going to show you what it looks like. It will need to authorize your account once more. Okay, so first right here, if you want to find a setting, you can directly search for it right here where it says enter keyword. Now I'm just going to go over the important ones from the left hand side right here. So first, plan and billing. As you can see, we have the option to close our account if we no longer want to use it, as well as change our plan. But I showed you a previous way of changing your plans if you want to upgrade or downgrade. So plan and billing. Account profile, here you will see all of your personal information, security settings. Okay, so this one is important, security settings, recipient authentication settings. So if you want the recipients to authenticate anything. As you can see right here, this one is by default. The sender can require the recipient must authenticate on any envelope sent from this account. You can read through these and choose the ones that are going to be best suited for your company. And account settings, if you don't use your account in DocuSign but you are signed in, it will time you out after 20 minutes. Okay, so these are the ones that I wanted to take a look from the account section, and right here are the other important ones: signing and sending. So we want to go to signing settings. Okay, so this is really important. So the recipients, the receivers of the, or the recipients of the documents. If a person wants to decline to sign, then you might check this, or you can check this to require a reason why they have decided to decline to sign. Okay, so right here you can allow recipients to sign on paper. You can read through this, and again, you can check the ones that are best going to be suited for your company's needs. You can allow senders to overwrite sign on a paper, allow recipients to sign on mobile device. Now, the really important part here is that you read through all of these ones that are checked and decide whether they are useful to you or not. Okay, so after you have selected the settings that are best suited for your needs, right here we can select the date format. Okay, so as you can see, we have different date formats. Now, the most generic one will be this one, at least for us Europeans. So the day, the month, and the year. And time format, you can use PM, AM, or of course the other time format that are seen, the other time formats that are seen right here. Now, arguably the other most important thing is how you want your signature to look. So as you can see, if you want a frame like so, it is going to be selected by default. So you will have your signature right here. But if you want just a simple signature without a frame, you can select do not add a frame. And of course, you have the envelope delivery options as well. So after you have changed all of the settings that you want right here, you can click on save. And the last thing that I want to look at is the sending settings. So as you can see right here, again, you need to go over the information yourself. You can select the font. So if we just press on edit right here, we can select the font for our sent documents and emails and letters. So the font is arguably one of the most important things that you have to change. As you can see, we can do Times New Roman 12, and of course the cover black, and then we can just click on OK. And of course, after all of these templates, or after you have read through all of this, you click on save. And again, you need to set this up for your own personal needs. I cannot stress this enough. So this is going to be my tutorial for DocuSign. I hope you managed to learn something out of it. Don't forget to like and subscribe if it was helpful in any way. I hope the website is useful to you, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.